Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Dmitry Reskin. My co-author is Elena Mirezka. She is a PhD student at Skolko Institute of Science and Technology. I will talk today about modeling bubble flow in a horizontal pipeline. Model itself was developed some time ago, and a corresponding paper has already been accepted into journal. Bubbles in turbulent flow are characterized by significantly larger sizes than droplets, so it's more difficult to break a bubble than droplet. According to Kolmogorov, bubbles and droplets are broken due to the interaction of turbulent eddies. Turbulent fluctuations cause fluctuations of dynamic pressure. Weber number is a convenient criterion to characterize forces in a turbulent flow, which act on a bubble or droplet. Critical Weber number for a droplet is approximately equal 1. Rousseau and Faber conducted experiments under microgravity conditions and found out that critical Weber number for a bubble in this case is equal approximately to 5. Microgravity conditions mean no gravity. Also, Rousseau and Faber emphasized that bubbles are strongly deformed prior to breakup. The same authors stated the finding of Sinhanji, who is Hind's PhD thesis, demonstrated that the critical Weber number of a bubble rising in turbulent flow is significantly reduced. Sinhanji studied bubble breakup in a downward flow, and he found out that in this case, critical Weber number equal to 0.25. It's 20 times smaller than in absence of bubble rising. We need to characterize bubble shape. For bubble shape characterization, it's convenient to use Weber number based on bubble rising velocity or terminal velocity. On the right side, we showed that the graph of terminal velocity versus equivalent diameter. The important conclusion from this figure is that bubbles maintain ellipsoidal shape in a wide range of diameters from 1 to 20 millimeters, and it's important. Let us consider ellipsoidal bubble. In this case, capillary pressure is non-uniform over its surface. It's easy to learn that minimum capillary pressure takes place either on the top or on the bottom of such a bubble. Levitch suggested to use minimum capillary pressure to characterize breakup conditions. Levitch conducted his investigation for bubble rising in a steel fluid, but we assume that this idea is also valid for turbulent conditions. Then we can find out that critical Weber number for rising bubble in a turbulent flow equal to the critical Weber number under microgravity conditions multiplied by ratio of radius of non-deformed bubble to the maximum radius of a deformed bubble. Considering an ellipsoidal bubble, we were able to get equation where critical Weber number of a rising bubble equal to critical Weber number of under conditions of microgravity multiplied by bubble aspect ratio e to the power 4/3. It was important to relate bubble aspect ratio and Weber number based on bubble rising velocity. For this purpose, we employed the Levitch approach describing bubble deformation. This approach is valid in the case when bubble is strongly deformed and bubble is relatively large. If these conditions are fulfilled, then we can assume that bubble has a cylindrical shape. As a result, we obtained the relation between bubble aspect ratio and Weber U. So, we have an equation for critical Weber number based Weber number under conditions bubble rising. And also we derived the equation for bubble aspect ratio. We substitute bubble aspect ratio in the equation for critical Weber number, obtain the equation for critical Weber number of horizon bubble as a function of Weber U. We can see that critical Weber number of horizon bubble is very rapidly reduced with an increase in Weber number based on rising velocity. We applied the equation derived to Sinhanji experimental conditions and found out that in this case critical Weber number for rising bubble equal to 0.47. That is not very far from 0.25 reported by Sinhanji, especially taking into account that measurements had no didn't have very high accuracy. In order to apply the derived equation for Weber number to CFD calculations, we need to get an equation for specific bubble breakup rate or breakup frequency. A few years ago, we derived an equation for specific bubble breakup rate, for specific droplet breakup rate. And this equation has already been published. What we did, we substituted the equation derived for critical Weber number for rising bubble into this equation for a droplet and obtained specific bubble breakup rate. Equation indicated by yellow. Next stage was model validation. We validated the model developed using the experimental data obtained for a bubbly horizontal pipe flow. The data were taken from a paper published in 1991. The pipe diameter was 2 inches, the length of pipe 9 meters. As a computational tool, we employed ANSYS Fluent CFD code. We incorporated the breakup model developed into Fluent through user-defined function. We also employed key epsilon realizable turbulence model. We employed also discrete population balance model. We selected coalescent model with constant probability, not standard choice, but it worked pretty well. And also took into account two major forces, turbulent dispersion force and virtual mass force. It's also important to note that we didn't use any tunable parameters. All model coefficients were set up by default. For validation, we used three data of three different experiments. The experiments were different by bubble holdup or bubble volume fraction. The measurements were done for pipe outlet cross section. The experimental data are shown by markers. The computed data by solid lines. In the upper row of figures, you can see the distribution of distributions of mean or bubble volume fraction over pipe outlet cross section. For the lower figures, one can see distribution of mean satay diameter, mean satay bubble diameter over outlet pipe cross-section. Mean satay diameter is an important characteristic of dispersed systems. From those figures, it's possible to conclude that computed data are pretty close to measured results, especially taking into account that accuracy of experimental data is limited. So we finally can emphasize that our results are nearly excellent. Now conclusions. A model of breakup of a rising gas bubble in turbulent flow has been incorporated into ANSYS Fluent CFD code. The model can be successfully validated versus experimental data obtained for a turbulent flow in horizontal pipe. Thank you for your attention. I'm ready for your questions.